Hey guys, Devin here with Admiral Off-Road, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to do a cooling system flush on your Jeep Cherokee. While I'm letting the Jeep cool down really quick, I'm going to go over what you're going to need to do this. First is going to be 2 gallons of the full-strength antifreeze. Now, don't get the 50-50 premix stuff. The reason is, when we do our flush here, there's still going to be some water left in the system. We're not going to be able to completely drain everything out. If we add 50-50 mix to the water already in there, it's going to dilute it. We're not going to get that 50-50 end mix that we want. I know that my system has 3 gallons, 3 gallon capacity, so all I'm going to do is I'm going to add 1.5 gallons of the full strength antifreeze and fill the rest up with water. For the water, I just got a big 2 gallon thing of distilled water. Now, you're going to want to use distilled water because water that comes out of your tap's got minerals in it and a bunch of stuff that you're not going to want in your cooling system. So this distilled water isn't going to have any of that. It's going to work out a lot better for you. Another thing is I got this radiator flush cleaner. It's just kind of a chemical flush. It's going to help clean all the stuff out of our cooling system. I know I've left mine for quite a while, so I'm going to run this through it and help clean everything out. Another thing is a bucket. You're going to want to catch all of your coolant. Don't let this drip on the ground. Dogs, animals really like the taste of it. It's really sweet, but it is poisonous, so please collect it and dispose of it properly. You're also going to need a screwdriver to get all your hose clamps off and a garden hose. That's how we're going to run our water through it. Before we get going on this, we want to make sure it's safe to open up our radiator cap. The way to do that is make sure your engine isn't hot. If you can feel either the cap's hot or you can feel a bunch of heat coming off the engine, don't open it yet. Another thing you can check is your radiator hose. If you squeeze it and you can either feel some coolant in there, or if you feel a lot of pressure, don't open it. I feel a little bit of pressure and it's still kind of hot, so I'm going to let it cool down a little bit more. Then when it cools down, we'll come back and start doing our flush. Alright, so we're cooled down enough, so we're going to start off by removing our radiator cap. Just in case, though, I'm going to use a towel and just try to be safe. Alright, yeah, we're good. Ooh, yeah. I don't know if you can see it. You'll see it when it comes out in the bucket. That's some pretty nasty looking coolant. Looks like I was quite overdue for this, so let's get started. Alright, so we got the cap off. We're ready to start draining the system. Now, these radiators do have a drain plug, but they're in a really, really bad spot. They're behind your passenger side headlight, and they're just really in a spot that you can't really get to. You have to take everything apart. So instead of going through that, I'm actually just going to go through my lower radiator hose, which is on the driver's side, and you can just look straight down here. I'll grab the camera and give you guys a look at what I'm going to be doing. Let's see here. So there's our drain, or our cap, and our lower radiator hose is right there, and you can see right there is where the hose clamp is that I'm going to be taking off with my screwdriver. If you look underneath, I've got a 5 gallon bucket under there, so I'm going to be catching all of the coolant that I take out, so I don't want to leak any of that on the street. We're going to let that drain for a second here, and then I'll give you guys a little look at it. Before we keep going, I just want to show you how bad that old stuff that we took out was. I mean, that looks like some pretty muddy water or something. To do our flush, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a hose, and I'm going to put it in where our radiator cap is. I'm just going to run some water through, and I still have my lower radiator hose disconnected. So what's going to happen is the water's going to go throughout the whole system, come out through the bottom of the hose, and it's going to hopefully take out any of the extra gunk in there and take it along with it. So, starting off nice and easy. There we go. Just flushing out all that stuff. Next thing I'm going to do is disconnect my upper radiator hose. From here, I'm going to pour water through the system. So I've kind of cleaned out my radiator already by putting water through the cap. Now I'm going to clean out the whole rest of the system. I'm going to put water through the upper radiator hose, let it run through, and I still have my lower radiator hose disconnected. So the water is just going to run straight through it and out through the bottom. So we're going to start off by disconnecting up here. This one's nice and easy to get to, which is very nice. So just a little hose clamp there. Move it out of the way. Just like that. And we're going to pull it off. Nice. Alright, so I'm going to take the hose and run through water, it this way. So same thing, I'm just going to let the water run until it goes all the way through the system and starts coming out the bottom, which it is. I want to catch as much of that as possible too. It's not straight cooling anymore, but there's still some in there, so I want to try and catch all of that. Make sure if you do leak any on the ground, please clean up after yourself. Again, lots of animals really like the taste of it, but it is poisonous. You're going to want to rinse out your overflow as well. So I just put a little bit of water in there and let that drain out, because you do have some of your fluid in there. So just let it all run through. Just a little update here. My overflow tank wasn't really draining all the way through, so instead of just letting it sit, I got a little pump. So I'm just going to pump it all out, suck it up, and put it in that bucket there. So it's going to take a little while, but it's not too big of a tank, so just suck it up and spit it out back in your bucket. Alright, so we've got everything drained now. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to put our hoses back on. We're going to fill the radiator up just with water and our chemical flush. Then what we're going to do is we're going to start the engine, we're going to let it warm up, so we're going to let it get all the way up to our operating temperature, and then what we're going to do is we're going to turn our heater on. Your heater core is part of your cooling system, or your coolant at least runs through it. So we're going to let our chemical flush run through that, we're going to drain it one more time, and then all we're going to do is, after we drain it, fill it up then with our fresh coolant and our distilled water. All right, we're all clamped up, so now it's time to add our water and our chemical flush to the system. All right, that looks nice and full. Put our cap back in. It is important to burp the system, so it's kind of what just happened there. It looks full for a second, but you want to leave your nose uphill. So I am parked on a little bit of a hill right now, and that's what you're going to want to do when you're burping your system. You want your nose uphill. That way all the air in the system can come out through your cap. So I let the Jeep run, let it cool down again. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take off that lower radiator hose one more time, drain all of our water out. We're going to hook it back up, then we're going to fill it up with our new coolant and our new distilled water. So, here we go. Starting off, taking off our lower radiator hose again. So we put the hoses back on, we got our drain and our flush done. Now we're going to fill it back up. We're going to put our coolant in first. Again, like I said, there's going to be water still trapped in the system. We didn't get everything out. So you want to make sure you put your coolant in first. This is a 3-gallon cooling system. So I know I need to add 1.5 gallons of my coolant first, and then the rest is going to be distilled water. So let me grab my coolant. So it's important to add this nice and slow when you're doing it. If you go too fast, you're going to do kind of like what I just did there and overfill it too quick, and it'll burp back out at you. Once you start filling it up, it's going to kind of start slowing down. I've put in all my coolant and I've started adding water, and I noticed it wasn't really going down very well. If you get this happening, all you got to do is you take your upper radiator hose and you just got to squeeze it a little bit, and that'll help to get all the air out of the system or burp it. So I see a lot of air bubbles coming out. And now I see the fluid level is dropping, so I'm going to be able to add a little bit more water. Do this a couple times, and then you're going to want to run the motor, run the engine, let all the coolant go through it again. That'll help suck it more down a little bit more, so you can add some more water and coolant in there. Once we got that engine started, it really sucked it all down. I was able to add a lot more water, which is good. Really getting all the air bubbles and everything out of the system, making sure we're flowing solid fluid. All right, thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, put them down below. And if you like what you saw here, please like and subscribe.